Hi fam, welcome back to another vlog. So it's our fifth day here in Hanoi, Vietnam. And nakabalik na tayo dito sa old quarter sa Hanoi. Dumating tayo kanina at around 4 a.m. sa bus stop. Tapos nakapag-check-in tayo dito sa hotel. Around 4:30 a.m. natulog muna kami ni Casby. And ngayon, 11:50 na ng umaga. Nakapag-beauty sleep talaga tayo, no? Bawing-bawi tayo ng tulog. Ang sarap ng tulog namin dito. And dilipat na tayo ng hotel kasi yung nabuko talagang hotel is Hanoi Delica Hotel. Pero ang check-in kasi noon is today at 2 p.m. So we had to book this hotel muna para makatulog kami. And surprisingly, yung hotel pala na ito, katabihan lang nung original na nabuk kong hotel. So lilipat kami ng hotel pero maglalakad lang kami kasi nasa iisang eskinita lang itong dalawang hotels na ito located. No? So hindi na kami kailangan mag-taxi pa. Although unfortunately, ulan sa labas. Ngayon lang kami nakaranas ng ulan dito sa Hanoi. No? Sa Sapa, may ulan and Ambon. Pero dito sa Hanoi, yung past few days natin wala. Pero ngayon, umuulan sa labas. So, we're gonna bring our umbrella. So, for today, nagbook kami ng tour sa Klook. So, ang pangalan ng tour na binook natin ay Hanoi Street Food Walking Tour with Water Puppet Show. Ilalagay natin yung screenshot dito. So, 2 p.m. magsa-start yung tour natin, no? And, nabook namin ito sa Klook for around 1,300 pesos each, no? And, marami ng mga spots na pupuntahan. Tapos, we get to see din yung water puppet show nila dito sa Hanoi. Although, I'm not sure if you can understand kasi wala yatang English yun. Pero, it's for the experience din, diba? At least, matry natin. So, yun ang gagawin natin. Alas 2 pa naman. So, may time pa tayo. Mag-aalas 12 pa lang. We have to check out na of this hotel. Tapos, lipat natin yung mga gamit natin dito sa kabila. Sa Hanoi Delica Hotel. Check na rin namin kung makakapag-check-in na rin kami doon, no? So, yun, tara. Baba na tayo. Okay, fam. Let's say goodbye to Hanoi Flora Hotel. Thank you so much for upgrading us to a family room. Super loved our stay here. Given a chance, no? Kung babalik ako sa Hanoi, I would choose this hotel. Super linis, maganda, very modern yung design. Ikaw, ano masasabi mo?
Maganda. Gusto ko siya.
Okay, let's go. Hindi ko pala na-share kahapon, no? Yung nasa bus, pagbaba namin ng bus from Sapa. Si Casvanessa kasi naunang bumaba. So, nung pagbaba niya, naisipan ko mag-check. Hindi ko alam bakit ko naisipan mag-check. So, yung cabin ko sa bus, chinek ko, baka may naiwan ako. Wala ko naiwan. Pagdingo ko sa kanya, naisipan ko i-check yung cabin niya. Alam niyo, fam, kung ano nakita ko. Cellphone niya, nandun sa ilalim ng kumot. Hindi, kinuha ko. Pasaway.
Nanaginip-taginip pa kasi ako.
Oo. Dutang-dutang pa.
Sure na ba talaga to? Ito na ba?
So yun yung story time. Nakakatawa na iwan niya yung phone niya sa cabin ng bus. Buti na lang nag-check ako talaga. Hindi ko alam bakit ko naisipan talaga
kaya,
mag-check.
Kaya sabi ko, buti naman, chinek mo. Ay? Hindi mo ganun pa yung salita ko sa'yo, pa. Buti naman, chinek mo.
Oo.
Papaakitin mo pa talaga ako, ah.
Tapos, di ko pa ni-reveal sa kanya. Hinintay ko munang hanapin niya. Nung magbubok na siya ng Grab, hinahanap niya na, wala na.
Kasi diba ako in charge mag-book?
Oo. Saka sa in charge mag-book ng Grab. Kaya yung hinahanap niya yung phone niya, wala. Nung na-realize niya wala na yung phone niya, aakit na siya sana sa bus. Pinigil ko na naawan mo lang ako kasi makikipagsiksikaw pa siya doon. Sabi ko, kung ito yung cellphone mo. Kinabahan daw siya. And let's go! Transfer na tayo ng hotel. Dito lang tayo sa kabila. So yung hotel natin, nandito lang din sa street na ito. Ang Hanoi Delica Hotel. Ayan na. Malapit na tayo. It's just a 1 minute walk lang from our hotel. Pero nakasang ulan ngayon, ha? Okay, here's our hotel, Delica Hotel. Oh no, ano pa? Ay, baha! Baha! Ayan o. Lakas ang ulan, fam! Oh. Ay, dito na kami. Buti na malapit na yung hotel natin. Wala lang crazy ng ulan. Lakas. Okay, akita tayo. Apparently, na-upgrade ulit tayo into a family room.
Pwede naman check-in.
Yeah, and we were allowed to check-in kahit na 12 pa lang. 2 p.m. pa talaga. One thing I noticed sa mga hotels dito sa Hanoi, sobrang accommodating nila. All the staff, front desk, managers, they really make it to a point na ipapa-feel nila sa'yo na welcome ka sa hotel. Even nung pag-alis namin sa kabila, sobrang tinanong kami, how was our stay? Ganon. Okay, fam, let's go!
Chinchow!
Pamalaki ng room natin. Bigyan ko kayo ng room tour. Okay, fam, quick room tour. So, ito yung pinto. Tapos, sasalubong sa atin ng isang queen bed. Parang isang kwarto na nga ito, di ba? Tapos may cabinet dyan. Here's the aircon. Tapos may dalawang side tables and lampshades. Ooh. Ayun na ang gamit ni Kaz. Tapos we have a toilet here. Gitna. Ang cute ang toilet nila, oh. It's clean. Okay, lavatory. And here's the toilet. Of course, may bidet. Oh, it's clean. Tapos shower area. And then, may isa pa tayong parang room pa dito. We have two single beds. Ayan. Dito na lang kami ni Cass. Ay, si Cass pala doon sa kabila. Para she has her own space. Para may sarili kang kwarto.
Ako nag-uwi ng kasama dito.
Oo. Para ma-feel mo naman na you have your own room, di ba? Tapos, ayan. This is ours. Twin beds. Okay. Tapos, meron tayong center table here. Here's the TV, tapos aircon. Yan yung, ito lang yung luggage natin. O, diba? Ang talo yung luggage natin, naulanan pa yan. Pero wag ka, oh. Still intact. Tapos, meron tayong table and two chairs. And ito, mga free daw ito. Tapos, meron tayong vanity area. Oh, cute. Cute ng kanilang vanity area. Initan ng tubig, hair dryer, tapos salamin. Tapos ang maganda dito, meron tayong balcony. Oh. First time natin makapag-stay sa hotel na may balcony. Yan ang view natin. Sa labas, ang old quarter, Hanoi. Yeah, that's it. Ang laki ng room natin ngayon. And we're gonna stay here until mag-checkout na tayo on the 22nd. Diba? Nice. Okay fam, that's it for the room tour. Again, this is Hanoi Delica Hotel and nabook namin ito sa Klook for around 2,700 pesos per night. And ang kagandahan, in-upgrade kasi tayo to a family room kaya sobrang laki ng room natin. If you also want to book this on Klook, you can use my code JM Bankisyo Klook para makakuha kayo ng discounts. Or kaya naman kung yung mahanap nyong hotel i-part ng Klook Spotlight Hotels program, you can use my code na JM Bankisyo Hotel, 8% discount. So yun fam, settle muna kami ni Cass, mag-ayos ng mga gamit. And then, lalabas tayo in a bit for our street food tour. Tawan-tawa kami ni Cass dun sa room niya.
Talaga?
Nasusyokot daw siya kasi yung chandelier daw, tas yung cabinet. Okay lang yan, diba? At least you have your own space. Nakalimutan ko palang pakita pa, meron pala tayo mini ref dito. Ayan, o diba? Nice. So nice the room. Thank you so much, Delica Hotel, for the upgrade. And nasa tuktok kami, fam. 7th floor ito. Yun nga lang yung elevator hanggang 6th floor lang. So we had to carry our luggage packet. Pero tinulungan naman kami nila kuya. So okay lang. Grabe no. Yun ang napansin ko sa lahat ng napagstayan. Ilang hotels na tayo, pangatlo na to. Sobrang accommodating ng lahat. So Hanoi is very particular in terms of hospitality. And being accommodating to the guests. I guess. Kasi tatlong hotels na yan pero same treatment. Lahat talagang super hospitable. No? Super okay. Ang ganda nung tourism industry dito sa Hanoi. No? Parang very trained talaga lahat. Kaya ang saya lang. Anyway, 2 pa yung tour natin. 12:35 pa lang. And yung meet-up point is yung office doon sa tour. 5-minute walk lang from here. So super aga pa. Pwede pa kaming mag-chill ni Cass. Coffee, you want coffee?
Anong drink coffee? Yung arte!
Yung arte mo, ha?
Pipagpad dyan!
Paano nakailang kape na yan sa trip na to? Siguro mga 20 na. Char! Sige na, pahinga ka muna dito. Mamaya ka na lang humiga doon sa kama mo.
Pag-gabi
na. Magdadala daw siya ng boylet doon sa kabila. 1:35 na. Nakalabas na kami ng hotel. And wala nang ulan. Grabe yung ulan kanina. Bagyo levels. Ngayon wala na, ayan. 5 minutes lang naman tayo maglalakad papunta dun sa meet-up point. Ito yung labas ng hotel natin. Okay, dito na kami. Crossing Vietnam Tour. Nag-text naman na sila sa Viber. Okay, we're gonna start the tour na. We're gonna visit like 5 to 7 different places daw. Pero mga small portions lang na daw yung itatry natin para we get to try everything. Tapos after nun, tayong puppet show natin. Yeah, say hi to our tour guide, si
Hello,
Alex.
Welcome to Hanoi.
Hi, thank you.
We don't have the food tour now. And you guys wanna love it.
Yeah. Well, nasagot lang ni Cass, thanks.
Yes, yes, no, thanks.
Kasi sabi mo, lang puro thanks.
Kaya mo na.
Yay! We're excited. Ayun, lalakad natin. So this is technically a street food walking tour. So parang food crawl siya. Tapos maglalakad lang dito sa old quarter. Ayan, naglalakad pa rin tayo. Dito lang sa kalagitnaan ng old quarter. I'm so excited. What will be our first stop? Ayan, naglalakad pa rin tayo. Pero nandito na tayo banda sa main St. Joseph's Cathedral. Diyan sa likod. I have my chisapan. So this is our first stop. Ang Banh Mi Mama. Ayan.
Salad bar and then some hot kitchen.
Oh.
We're going to have a most Hanoian typical flavor, which is pate. It's a pate there. It is a very French flavor.
Okay.
So the signature of this place is the pate flavor. They make it very good pate. We want to taste it now. They make it very nice bread texture, which is this one.
Yeah.
It must be crusty from the outside, but soft inside. So in here, they make very good texture of the bread.
Good that it's small portion, so we can eat a lot
for the next.
Yeah, let's try it.
Okay, what is the first texture that you you say?
It's crunchy.
It's crunchy.
Yeah,
that is right. And do you think it's very soft in the middle?
Yeah,
it's crunchy outside, but soft in the middle.
It's really soft in the middle.
But it's just like a typical texture of the of the bread. And about the flavor, what about the flavor?
Mm. Oh my god, so good.
Mm-hmm. Did you taste a little pate in that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. So we make the pate as a traditional options in Hanoi. But we try to make the pate not too smelly.
Sarap.
Kain tayo.
Don't be shy.
She's shy.
Okay.
She said you are handsome.
Thank you. Okay, emotion. What's your emotion, Vanessa? Okay, good.
Emotion.
Nakakatawa yung emotion. Uy, grabe, ang sarap ng Banh Mi Mama, ha? Next, pupuntahan natin yung favorite daw ni tour guide na spot. His favorite spot. Right, Alex? We're gonna go to...
Oh, yeah. We're going to my favorite.
His most favorite spot.
In Hanoi.
In Hanoi.
Oh, I'm the person who likes refreshing food.
Yeah.
Not too heavy, not too oily.
Yeah.
So next one will be the very healthy.
Okay.
Yeah.
What can you say? Yes.
No thanks.
No thanks. Naiya siya kausapin si Alex na siyang guwapo daw.
Hindi kasi nung sinabi ka, magpadikit kami eh. Oh. Nakita mo ba yung itsura namin?
Oh, oh.
Ang lapit lang ng face. Ang inaantay niya yung reaction ko.
Oh, oh. So nailang ka?
Nailang ako.
Ayun na, naglalakad pa rin kami. Malapit na to sa hotel natin, fam. Yung Delica Hotel. So chill lang din naman maglakad si tour guide. So chill lang din kami. Marami naman tayong time. Here's our next stop. Yeah. Lucky daw tayo kasi we're doing this tour on a weekday kaya wala masyadong tao. Banh Kwon Noong Buncha. favorite daw to ni Alex. So, ito yung kitchen nila.
Kitchen here.
Okay.
He has a white liquid, which is the rice butter. So, rice and water with the perfect ratio to have the perfect texture.
Okay.
He's going to spread a very thin layer into the steamer. It is a fabrics and hot water underneath. A steamer.
Yeah.
Homemade.
Wow.
1 minute. It become a rice thin for the skin. And he's going to use the finger to roll the skin with the corn mushroom filling, which is the traditional one.
Oh, okay.
So this one has no secrets, but they have family experience because they know how much rice powder and water in there to have the perfect texture, which is this one.
Oh, wow.
And the skill is another secret. He has to learn to do this from the family member. You have the good skill to keep everything like this. And use the finger to do that. There we go.
Wow.
I'm going to give you...
Love it. Mm.
Two different flavors.
Okay.
Pork is a typical, and we're going to have one steamed egg flavor. So he's doing the same, but he's going to put the egg into the middle.
Okay. Galing. Fresh na fresh pala siyang ginagawa. Yung may egg. Ayan na, may egg na yung loob niya. Yun, no? Nice! Okay, pasok tayo!
Fish sauce base, but they have water and then hot water and some sugar.
Oh, may gulay!
What we are going to do now is... The same idea everywhere. You're going to have extra flavor. Extra flavor everywhere in every place. It normally is balanced enough. If you are the spicy lover, you can do that. If you love the balance, you can go with this. Okay, and they have this, which is a salad, so you can eat between the meal, so it's like refresh your flavor.
Mm.
If you're happy with that, you don't want extra flavor, you can go with this bit.
Yeah. What do you call this again?
Banquen.
Banquen.
Yes.
This is banquen. Did I say it right? Banquen.
Yes, that is right.
Okay, banquen. Kasi, you say banquen.
Banquen.
No? If I say in Vietnamese, it will be very challenging, but the accent I'm giving you is more like touristy accent.
Okay.
If I had to say 100% Vietnamese, it would be Bánh Cuốn.
Bánh Cuốn?
Yeah. Bánh Cuốn. It's not very easy to have 100% the accent. But what you have done is good enough.
Okay,
I'm going to tell you how to do this. I'm going to show you with this. Normally, we're going to have just the chopsticks. You can have this as a support. So you go here. So you pull it into the spoon. One piece. They have like about 8 pieces.
Okay.
And you dip it down on the soup and you eat everything from the spoon. Okay, there you go.
Thank you. Let's try our banquen.
So this this our lunch today. Do you have a big lunch?
No.
Well prepared.
Yeah, it's so refreshing.
Good texture.
Yes.
And it's light. That's why I like this one.
Yeah, it's very light. What's inside the dish? Pork.
Pork and mushroom.
Mushroom. Yeah. Mushroom. Let's try the egg one.
Yes.
Same?
So this one is quite hot temperature because they steam the entire piece of egg.
Yeah.
So take a small bite.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a very popular
and well known
about the egg, right? But today, I want to try the dry
version. It's good.
Dry version is exactly
you say salam is good in the Philippines.
Salam.
Salam.
It's good.
Sarap.
Sarap.
Yeah, sarap.
Yeah. Masarap.
Masarap.
Okay.
Masarap.
Okay. I've learned some Filipino word for the fruits. That's like delicious. I have no idea. Sarap. In here we have just the same thing like Filipinos have. We got the artis, we got macopa, rambutan.
Same.
Yeah.
Rambutan din tawag sa kanila. Atis, macopa, mangga, no?
Mango is mango.
Yeah.
Okay, you call it mangga. Yes, we do have mango. Mangga
in Tagalog, mango in English.
Yeah.
Mansanas.
I just forgot another one. There is a... I should show you the picture. I just forgot the Filipino word of this.
Okay.
I love to learn some Philippines.
Yeah. How was it?
Okay, paman, sarap. Very light. Yun nga lang, medyo mahirap bigkasin yung name. Banquen? Medyo mahirap. Pero it's good. Ayan siya. Banquen, no. Ayan na. Ayan siya. Steamed rice paper. Yung kinain natin.
Giving donuts. She was giving us donuts.
Yeah. Scam pala yun.
She's just giving you like friends. And then, this is a scam because she charged a lot of money from tourists.
Oh.
It can be like 5 or 10 times more expensive.
Yeah.
Then we have to pay.
Wow.
Just not very good. It's not a good donut.
Okay.
The second scam is the rickshaw.
What?
Rickshaw.
Cycle. A rickshaw, yes.
There we go. Here. Red bicycle. Again, they overcharge tourists a lot.
Yeah.
Like, it can be like 5 times more than we have to pay.
Yeah. That's true.
The third is taxi is most common. Taxi scam.
Taxi scam.
Grab is good.
Mm-hmm.
You know Grab?
Yes,
you
Grab.
In Philippines.
Yeah. Yeah.
Grab is good because it's just same everywhere. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to the taxi, they're gonna cheating people on the meter. So the meter gonna show the price.
But
they tell you have to pay more than the price on the meter.
Yeah.
I can give you an example is. The meter gonna show you 24.0, which is 24,000 dong.
Yeah.
But the taxi driver gonna tell you this is 240,000.
Oh.
So it's like 10 times. And that's happened a lot.
Wow. That's scary.
Number four. This is the most dangerous.
Yeah.
Because you have to charge a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Shoes cleaner. If you're walking down the street, there are some people who sit next to you. Sit on the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Just look at the shoes of everybody, and he always has a basket, red basket or black basket.
Yeah.
And we know that he is a shoes cleaner. He is going to take your shoes off your feet.
Mm-hmm.
He loves to do that because once he got the shoes on the hand, he's going to put the nail on the shoes. Or he's pretend to fix the shoes.
Yeah.
And then he asks for a lot of money, which is a lot of money. Which is like
a lot?
like 100,000 to 200,000.
Wow.
Because he put the nail on the shoes. It's
It's
more like bullying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Number five is not very serious, but you don't want to get this scam. You just come, very common.
Yeah.
When you walk down the street, there are so many massage places pulling you into the place.
Yes.
And normally these places, because they're pulling you, they have the cheap price showing you on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Like $12, $15 for 60 minutes.
Yeah.
Which is too cheap for a good massage. So if they're pulling you and they have the very cheap price, it should be a scam because they're going to give you not very good massage, and sometimes they're gonna overcharge when you get inside.
Yeah,
five scams in here.
Okay, ayun. Na-share na ni Alex ang 5 scams in Hanoi. At least now, alam na natin, di ba? The one that we experience is the rickshaw. Right, Cass? Yung rickshaw, yung pedicab.
Ah, yeah.
Did you do the rickshaw?
Yeah, kwento mo yung sa rickshaw.
Rickshaw.
And
they want us to pay 200.
For how many minutes? How long?
We checked with GrabCar, it's only 32.
$32. That's right. So normally the price the tour guy can ask, because you know, you have the connection with the cycler is 70,000 dong, which is like $3.
Yeah.
For 45 to 60 minutes.
Wow, really?
Per person. If you go like 2 person on one cycler,
yeah,
it should be like I would say like 100 to 120,000 dong for 45 minutes.
Okay.
It's much cheaper. But if you are tourists, 300,000.
Oh, ganun pala. Here's our next stop, Maya Kitchen. Pasok tayo sa alley. Yan. Yan siya. Oh, cute. Itong daanan nila. Okay, we're here on our next stop. Kanina yung napakita namin yung 5 scams to avoid in Hanoi. No? Shiner ni Alex. So dito, ano ka kayo natin class? Noodles? Noodles. Parang nabusog na ako. Pangalawa pa lang busog na tayo. No?
Alakalahati.
Pero sabi ni tour guide, anong daw? Half-half nga lang daw yung pinag-order nila sa atin. Half lang din daw sa rice paper. So dito, half-half lang din. Kasi may iba pa tayo pupunta. Pangatlo pa lang ito. Ito yung view natin, ang ganda. Diba?
You want spicy or you want regular?
Regular.
Okay, so we don't need extra spicy.
What do you call the dish?
This is the fresh roll.
Fresh spring roll.
Not the spring roll, but I call it fresh roll.
Oh.
Normally, we don't have the English name for all of this roll in Vietnam because they are so typical. But I can translate this one into English, which is a fresh roll because it tastes very refreshing.
Okay.
It's good for summer. So the skin is very typical in Hanoi because fresh rice noodle, which is daily made. So we're not going to have this outside of Vietnam because there's just so many places they make it here and they use for the day only. So after overnight, it cannot stay overnight.
Nice.
It just daily made in the morning. So it's very refreshing skin. And inside there are so many herbs, carrots and beef flavor. So it's like a fresh roll.
Yeah.
Because it's refreshing.
Okay.
So what you're going to do is you can use the chopstick, forks or finger as you want.
Yeah.
And you dip it here.
Okay.
And eat it.
Okay.
Yes. Go ahead.
Let's try it. Wow!
Is it refreshing?
Yeah.
It's very good for the summer. That's why I love this
In
the summer. And it's nutritious because you have all of the herbs,
yeah.
Beef in it.
Beef. Sarap. Sarap ng beef. Natapunan ka na. Love it!
Summer version, so it looks very refreshing, very colorful, a lot of herbs, and there's no hot soup. They have just some kind of mixing sauce.
Yeah. Let's try it.
Do you want forks, chopsticks?
Chopsticks.
Chopsticks.
Thank you. Oh, ang sarap! Para siyang pansit canton sa atin, Cas. I like it very much.
The mixing sauce makes the things quite balanced.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ang sarap, fam, oh. Para siyang pansit canton sa atin. Parang pansit canton sa atin.
Have you ever asked a question like why we are the tropical country? Which is very hot, but Vietnam, China, I'm not sure in the Philippines, do you eat a lot of soup?
Yeah.
Have you? So yeah, can you explain why we eat a lot of hot soup and we are the hot country?
Oh, why?
I think we have the same idea about that. Like when you was a child,
Your parents always say that you have to eat everything, no wasting.
Yes.
So it's about wasting, because we don't want to waste anything from the animal. So the soup comes from the bone. So you not throw the bones away. You have the soup from the bone. Yeah. That's why we have. That's the reason. It's not about the taste, but it's about money.
How did you know about that?
I just conclude myself. Okay. Because I got the same question in the tour. And then I was agree, like, if the weather is cold, it tastes very good with the hot soup.
Yeah.
But like now, if so I ask good. You to have the hot soup, it doesn't taste 100% good. So yeah, they asked the question and I had to think about the question like about 5-10 minutes and then I got the answer. That's a good answer because we all know that we don't want to waste the bones of the animal.
Yeah.
Yeah. During the tour, I learned quite a lot of things because sometimes they ask the questions, very interesting questions. That we never think about before, and then I just have to think to have some idea why this happened, and then the answer is quite something good to learn. You can see small houses outside the old quarter, but you will see a lot of small houses in here, even more than outside, because we didn't have a chance to see much. But if you pay your attention on the street or even this building, do you remember when we get into this building? It looks like the one building, but they have two different entrances. So right hand side is some kind of shops, and left hand side is the alley we are coming into. So the house, the entire house, owned by one person. But when the person has the children, they have to split the house, different part for the children. So this whole building can be like five different children. So the children, the first one, or the children who love to have the business, gonna take the one in front, which is the shop down there.
I see.
If they just want to have a shop, which is a hidden shop, if they want to have a private house without any business, so they wanna take the house inside the alley. So that's why they have the alley. It looks like one building, but they have two entrances. So alley is a public entrance for the house. There are some alley, looks very small from the outside. When you get inside, they have the big yard to put the motorbikes because they live inside. Maybe like three or four families live inside. They have to have a big space to do the public parking motorbikes. So yeah, this answer your questions.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Mm. Yes.
Yeah. Yes. No.
Yes. No. Yeah.
Yes. No. Thank you.
Okay. So far, ito yung pinakamasarapan ako. Para kasi siyang yakisoba sa atin. Sarap. Next stop na tayo, yung donut naman. Sabi ni Alex, do you remember the first coming about sa donut? Sabi niya, okay, kakain tayo ng donut. Blackbird, no? Yeah, what's that smell?
So in the old quarter, the streets are very small, and normally the entire street they're going to have one allocated items for sale.
Ah.
For example, we are here in the very small street, and in the entire street they're having the Chinese
spices,
medications. More medications and spices.
Ah, okay.
That's like that.
Oh,
so they're all from herbs, from forest place, and it's very smelly. The Chinese medication. It smells very bitter.
Yes.
If you're going to other street, you see different items. There may be
metal
or silver.
Yeah. No. That's why in our street there are a lot of toys.
That is right.
Yeah. Okay. So naka-section daw pala yung mga bilihan dito. So ito, section ng Chinese medicinal herbs market. Ganon. Ganon pala siya.
Ayan na. Designed like a big market. People can navigate based on the name of the street.
I
find an item they are looking for.
That's cool.
It's changed a lot now because of tourists.
Mm-hmm.
So they have more hotel, more tour offices.
Yes.
But there are some streets that still keep it the same. For example, this one.
Yeah. Daming gatas. Baby sack. Ensure pala gusto mong bilhin nila. Ito mga alak. Okay. Sabi ko kanina, gusto ko yung tour na to kasi you get to explore more of the old quarter, tapos yung mga hidden gems, yung mapupuntahan ng kas.
Saka
perfect din yung pagkuhan natin kasi weekday.
Oh, weekday daw. Walang masyadong tao.
Which is true naman.
Oh, correct. Yun yung donut natin. Take out daw tayo ni Alex, tapos dadali natin sa coffee shop. Okay, now nakapag-take out na tayo. We're gonna go to a coffee shop daw. Ang ganda naman ng alley na to.
We still have a couple of local corners in the old quarter if we know where to go.
Okay.
It's just like 5 minutes away from the touristy area. We can go to this place.
Okay.
It is just beautiful.
Highlands Coffee. Lakad-lakad lang, chill-chill lang. Okay. Ito daw yung recommended niyang massage.
Do you want to have a reference?
Yeah.
The price.
Yan natin. Ito daw yung pinaka-recommended niyang massage parlor dito. Kasi daw legit. Try natin to, Cas. Yeah, we wanna try this one of these days. Okay, ito daw ang Beer Street.
That's why the streets are getting so busy after dinner when people come here for drinks.
Yeah, right. Okay.
So it's so pricey because they're 100% for tourists and it's so noisy. People
really?
Wanna pull you into the shops because there are so many shops here.
Yeah, palang para sa turista daw talaga. Ang Beer Street. So ito pala yung original na Beer Street. Tapos nag-expand na lang dito sa labas. You know.
It was beautiful and quiet.
Yeah.
But not off the eight.
Like every day?
Every day.
Really?
Especially in the weekends.
Oh, okay. Ganun pala. The story of the Beer Street. Okay, we're here on our next stop. Nandito tayo sa Cafe Man. Yeah, napuntaan na rin natin ito nung nakaraan. Kasama natin si Tommy. Anong pangiti si Kaso sinabing Tommy?
Yes. This is my recommendation.
Okay.
Okay. They have two options for the egg coffee. You can have hot egg coffee, which is more traditional, and you can have iced egg coffee, which is more refreshing.
Yeah. I'll go with iced.
Iced.
I go with hot.
Iced. Okay.
No, hot.
You go with hot. Okay.
Inaanok namin siya umorder kasi sa one na raw siya. No? Kasi
okay,
everyday pa naman
we are going to have this one. Let's start with how they make this one. So it looks very small like this. I'm not sure you can see from that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
The skin is sticky rice powder. So the lady in the place going to use a finger to make the shape of this with a sticky rice powder for the skin. And in the middle of that they have a little filling, which is mung beans.
Mung
beans. Mango in the Philippines.
Mango?
Not the fruits. It's the mung beans or the
mung
yellow
beans.
Okay, for the inside of the filling, and then they want to deep fry it. When they deep fry it, the skin will expand. That's why when you take one and you shake it, you can hear a little sound inside, which is the mango, mung beans sound.
Amunggo!
Munggo.
Call it munggo.
Okay. I forgot some Philippines, sorry.
You said mango, so I thought it was mango fruit.
I forgot some Filipinos.
Okay.
I'm picking up now.
Yeah.
You are the first Filipino in 2 weeks when I just back to Vietnam.
Okay.
Okay. I ordered for you 3 different labels of sweetness. We're gonna start with the original, white sugar and brown sugar. They are all sweet. They have just like less sweet, medium, very sweet.
Okay.
However, we are not the people who eat a lot of sweet food. That's why it's sweet, but it's not something you expect.
Okay.
Too sweet. Okay, you can take the one which is the original with the sesame seeds.
Okay.
Shake it before you eat it.
Oh, it's still hot.
Did you shake it? Did you hear something inside?
No.
Okay. Not lucky that time.
Okay. No.
Okay. Do you still have two more chances?
Okay. Kailangan daw i-shake.
Let's eat it. If you take the first bite, open it, you want to see the yellow.
Okay.
That is a mungo.
Mungo. Ay, sarap ba? Parang siyang gucci sa atin.
It's good. Chewy, crispy because of sticky rice, deep fried. And it just sweet enough. You just know the balance of the flavor.
Yeah. Sarap! Love it.
Let's try. You hear something?
No.
I'm not lucky today. I wish number 2 and number 3 you're gonna have the sound.
Okay.
Sometimes it's not expanding enough, or sometimes it's sticking to the skin so you cannot feel the sound. But so the other two is harder than that one, so it should have
okay.
sound. But yeah, the skin is chewy because of sticky rice.
Oh yes, I got it. Woohoo! I can feel it. What's this?
Sugar.
It is the second. Not a problem. It is the second sweetness. Lemon tea. And this is a white sugar.
Sorry, okay.
Not a problem, now, that's okay.
Tatawa kami. Tapos si Kyo kinakain kay Alex. Tawa-tawa, oh.
Nakitawa ko kasi.
Ano?
Tumal si Kyo.
We want a second one.
Si Alex, ano lang. Chill lang.
No, that is not a problem. Don't worry. So these two flavor is the original one. But they have an extra step, which is stir fry with extra sugar.
Yeah.
White sugar or brown sugar?
Yeah. Sarap. But I like the original one.
The sesame.
I like the last one. Really? I think you're gonna like the last one.
Okay.
I hope this one will be your favorite because it's my favorite.
Okay.
Brown sugar. Okay, good.
Brown sugar.
And again, you should have the sour with this one because it's a very hot skin.
Yes.
To you.
Yes, the sour.
It's sweeter than the original, but it's a good sweetness. Oh, that's why that's my favorite.
Yeah. I like it. You're right. What's up?
You.
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Parang siyang donut sa atin. Or buchi. Sarap. Okay, let's say goodbye to our tour guide, Alex.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Alex. Thank you guys for seeing us today. It was a very nice experience.
Yeah. So kung gusto nyo mag-book, ayan, request for Alex.
Next time, I will see you guys as a tour guide again.
Yeah. Okay fam, 2 hours lang yung tour. And ilan lang yung pinuntahan. Pero nakakasatisfy, no? Ang sarap ng mga pagkain. What's your favorite?
Ito naman.
Pero anong pinaka tumatak sa'yo?
Banmi. Kasi nakailang banmi tayo.
Pero yun yung pinakamasarap eh. Correct.
May hinahanap tayong banmi.
Oo. Tsaka yung banmi, alam mo yung umpisa pa lang, ano na, winner na. Sarap, no? Tapos for around 1,300 pesos, not bad. You have a local tour guide na maglalakad with you. Tapos mag-visit ng mga hidden spots dito sa Hanoi. Okay na yun, fam. So, 2 hours. Try nyo din yan. Ayun si Kasi. Happy?
Yes. At saka yung mga binadagin niya sa akin. Hindi ko matanong na sa akin. Pero,
pili naman siya. Happy. Okay. Diba? Saya. Again, if you want to book this on Klook, ilalagay natin yung screenshot dito, pati yung link sa description box below, tapos gamitin nyo yung code ko na JMBankisyo Klook para may discounts kayo. Natuwa ako kasi kanina, sabi pala ni Alex, sa 6 na taon niyang pagtutour guide, ang pinaka-favorite daw niyang mga tinutour is yung mga Filipinos. Kasi 1, mababait daw. 2, magaling daw mag-English. Tuwan-tuwa daw siya kasi mas madali siya makipag-communicate sa mga Filipinos kasi nga magagaling daw mag-English. Tapos, mga kwela daw. Ayun, kaya happy naman. Ngayon, 5:20 pa kasi yung schedule natin sa Water Puppet Show. 4 o'clock na tapos yung tour, 4:20 pa lang. So, ay isang oras pa kami ni Cass. Maglalakad-lakad muna dito sa Old Quarter or sa lake. Okay, naglalakad na tayo from sa Bear Street. Papunta tayo sa lake. Tinuruan naman kami ni tour guide kung paano pumunta sa lake. So sana nakuha namin ang tama. Okay, dito na kami sa center ulit. Naalala niyo yung night market na pinunta natin, fam? Dito yon. Ito yung malaking building na Highland. Yung sikat na coffee building. Okay, tapos na kami mag-TikTok ni Cass. Ayan, featuring the Highlands building, coffee building here in Hanoi. Ngayon, maglalakad-lakad tayo sa lake.
Let's go.
May nakita tayo mga fam here Hi. Sa Hanoi. Hello po. Oh, nice to meet you. Bye-bye. O diba, sayo na nakakita tayo ng fam dito sa Hanoi. Dito na tayo sa lake. Oh. Ito na yung lake. Hi.
Welcome sa Hong Kim Lake.
Hong Kim Lake.
Hong Kim Lake.
Sa gitna ng Hanoi. Kami ay nag-chill-chill lang dito dahil may schedule tayo ng Water Puppet Show at 4:20 p.m. Halika-lakad tayo papunta dito, fam. 5 minutes lang daw yung lakad papunta dun sa Puppet Show. So pag sa Puppet Show, hindi na kayo sasamahan ng tour guide. Although si Cass, parang gusto pa niya sasama yung tour guide. Oo. Parang gusto niya hanggang mamaya pa yung tour guide. Ito na yung Hanoi City Tour Bus. Hop on, hop off na bus. Ayan, nagpipicture si Cass. Hanoi City Tour. Dito lang yung Water Puppet Show. Ah, dito pala yung bilian ng ticket. I can see Korean brands here, oh. Loteria. Hong Kim Lake. Hi! Levi's. Ayan, we're here na. Nahat Mua Roy Tanglong. Water Puppet Show. Let's go, Cass! Ayan siya, oh. 5:20 show! Come on! So, ito yung ticket office nila. Oh, ito yung weekly show schedule nila. Dito tayo sa 5:20. So, again, itong ticket natin sa Water Puppet Show kasama natin sa tour na binook natin sa Klook, yung 1,300, no? So, sulit na siya. Tingnan niya, fam. Marami tayong kasabay na manonood ng show. Time check, it's 4:55. 5:10, pwede na lang umakyat. Ayan siya. Tapos, ito yung entrance. Paakyat doon. Ayan na, nagbababaan na yung 6:10 na show. Excited na kami for the experience ng Water Puppet Show dito sa Hanoi, Vietnam. Well, si Alex, gusto mo yung WhatsApp?
Oo, gusto mo yung
WhatsApp. Ano may yan? Okay, pasok na tayo. Let's go. Tanglong. Ooh, ganun pala siya. Wow, ganda naman ng theater nila. Ang lamig. Ganda, oh. Ang cute, parang makalumang sinihan sa atin. No, Cass? Parang yung sinihan sa Ever Gutesco Grand. Cute. Ayan. Ayan siya. Ayan na. Start na. Or 50 minutes to the exam. Tapos sa show! Yeah, ang saya, no? Although hindi namin naintindihan. Pero ang ganda kasi ng music. Yung musicality. Original music kasi yung gamit sila yung nagpe-play. Tapos yung mga instruments sila. Galing. Done with the show. 6:20 na ng hapon ngayon.
Yung culture nila dito yung pinag-true. True puppet. talaga.
So, masaya?
Yeah, oo. Meron siyang aral.
Would you recommend it?
Oh, actually, mare-recommend ko din siya. Tapos sa mga bata, more on siguro dahil puppet siya, kaya na-appreciate.
Yeah.
It's pero okay. Sa mga sa atin, mm. Ano yung culture itself?
Ano yung matutupin? Aray.
Pinagandaan
yung review. At tinilakad namin pa. Maraming mga tindahan dito. Yeah, it's good. I would recommend it. Maganda. It's a nice experience here in Hanoi.
Kaya pala sa mas
busy. Yes. Yeah, naglalakad na kami pabalik ng hotel and nakita namin itong King Roti. Meron silang katulad ng binibili natin sa Malaysia na Roti Boy na coffee and butter. Tingnan natin kung same. Mura lang naman, parang 20,000 Vietnamese dong. Okay, let's try the King Roti. Kung same pa siya ng Roti Boy sa Malaysia.
Mm.
It's good. Okay. Hindi siya katulad ng Roti Boy sa Malaysia. Gantong-ganto yung recipe niya. Pero iba pa rin yung lasa ng Roti Boy. Masasarap pa rin. Sorry. And we're back. Delica Hotel. Okay, akit naman tayo sa room farm. 6:40. Papahinga na muna kami ni Cass. Magsa-charge ng mga gadgets. And labas ulit tayo mamaya for dinner. Alright, we're here sa room. Ang laking bagay na may balcony tayo. Alam natin ang nangyayari sa labas. Kaya nagsishare na ako ng files kay editor for uploading. Na si Cass. Ang ganda ng room natin, Cass, no?
Yeah.
Love it. Okay, fam.
CCTV.
Ayan na, nandito na tayo sa room. Ang lakas baka CCTV ng ating camera, di ba? Lalo sama na namin mag-Bear Street tonight. Kaso, may tour pala kami ulit bukas. Tsaka parang babawi pa ulit kami ng tulog kasi diba galing tayo sa biyahe kagabi tapos natulog ng saglit tapos umalis ulit. Grabe yung pagkabasa namin kanina fam, diba? Nakas ang ulan. Bagyo levels, kakalurks.
Pero ano naman kasi yung bagyo?
Pero saglit lang diba? Saglit lang umulan. Okay fam, so it's 8:20 na ng gabi and ready na kami lumabas ni Cats. Yan ang situation ng ating room. Nag-freshen up lang konti. Para fresh-fresh naman tayong lalabas. Ayan. Slippers na lang po tayo for today's video. Gamit ko na lang slippers ng hotel. Okay, nakalabas na kami ng hotel. Pag-uusapan namin ni Cass na ang mura talaga dito sa Vietnam. Di ba sinasabi ko na yun sa inyo, fam? Ngayon na-experience na ni Cass. Ano masasabi mo?
Gusto kong bumalik.
Kasi sobrang affordable ng lahat talaga. Hindi siya mura, pero affordable. Oo. Masarap balik-balikan kasi everything is affordable talaga. From accommodation, pagkain, transportation tours. Yes. Naglalakad kami ngayon pabalik doon sa may Highland building, no? Kasi doon tayo kakain ng Hainanese chicken rice. Tadaanan namin kanina ni Cads. So yun yung kakainan natin. Yung mga ganitong kainan nga lang sa gilid, masarap na eh. Itong mga dress kaso, dali ka na. Dorian. Mga souvenir items. Ayan na, lapit lang natin dito sa ano, no? Building, Highlands Coffee Building. Tapos dyan na yung lake. Dito yung night market kas, di ba? So, sinasara siya pag weekends. Okay, tawira na! Bukas! O, diba? Kailangan lang don't hesitate. Do not hesitate. Yes. So, na yung kakainan natin. Soup ga. Tanyen. Ayan o. Para silang Hainanese chicken rice. Yay! Ah, dito pala. Okay. Ayan o. Wow! Love it. Hainanese chicken. Tapos meron din silang banh mi. Chicken soup o. Ooh! Okay. Pamon, sarap ng food natin. We have rice. Turmeric siguro to. Tapos yung chicken innards. And Hainanese chicken salad. And itong sarap nito kasi. That's it! Okay, done with our dinner. Sarap, grabe. Our bill is 300,000 Vietnamese dong. Dalawa na kami ni custom kasi set nun yung in-order namin. So, ito nga siya. Soup ga tan yen. Madali lang siya mahanap kasi nandito yung Highlands Coffee Building. Ayan. So, dito lang siya banda. Tapat lang ng Levi's. If you're planning to go here. Diba? Very nice. Ito na ulit yung center. Lapit lang natin, no? Old Quarter. Minsu. Tanghulu. And Holo Candy. Dito tayo dadaan. Ito yung nadaan na namin kanina. Tapos nakita namin ang daming kumakain ng dessert. So, magde-dessert tayo ni Kaz. Hobyaw! Okay, dito daw tayo upo. Hobyaw! Oh, di ba? How cool is that? We're gonna have dessert along the street. Hobyaw. Ano siya? Traditional dessert dito sa Vietnam. Para siyang crushed ice, tapos may milk and may mixed fruits. Yung mixed fruits, pwedeng choices. Pwedeng puno mango, watermelon. Pero nakita ko kanina may mixed eh. Parang fruit salad gano'n. Ayan yung menu nila oh. Ito yung nakita kong mixed fruits oh. 30K. Wakwada mixed fruits. Ayan ka na lang. Ah, sige, dito na lang ako sa caramel fruits. Okay. Okay, here's our dessert. Caramel fruits. Kay Cass ay yogurt fruits. Tapos ice. In fairness, fam, ang sarap ng fruits. Una ko natikman yung langka. Sarap. Parang siyang halo-halo. Ha? Huh? Oh, watermelon. Amis? Meron ding mansanas. Parang talaga siyang halo-halong fruit salad. Fam. Sobrang sarap. Ito na yata ang pinakamasarap na dessert na natikman ko dito sa Vietnam. The fruits, sobrang sarap ng mga fruits. The best. Simple lang siya, no? Pagano-anong fruit lang, yelo lang. May langka, papaya, avocado, may gelatin, dragon fruit, meron din. The only fruit na hindi ko nagustuhan is yung strawberry. Yun lang pa, hindi ko na nagustuhan is the strawberry kasi medyo maasim. Pero lahat ng fruits, super sarap. Tapos simpleng dessert lang siya, yelo lang siya, tapos fruits. Although yung sa amin ni Cass may yogurt, tsaka parang may gelatin ba yun. Sarap! Try nyo dito. Ayan o, kita nyo naman sobrang daming kumakain. Ibig sabihin, masarap talaga siya. Alright, we're back sa ating hotel room. It's currently 9:40 na ng gabi. And sakto lang, di ba? Pero busog pa kami ni Cass dahil sa dessert natin na fruits. Ito yun, fam. Hashtag JM recommends. Super sarap.
Hashtag JM recommends. Yes. Super sarap.
Super duper sarap. Grabe ang bilis ng time, no? Ika fifth day na natin today dito sa Hanoi, Vietnam. And tomorrow, 6th, 7th day. On the 8th day, uwian na. Grabe. Nasa half way na pala tayo ng tour natin sa Hanoi. And so far, we're loving it, no? Cass, ano mo sabi mo sa Hanoi trip natin so far?
Hindi boring na sa Hanoi. Buhay na buhay.
Ang daming magandang, akala daming pwedeng na, gawin, no?
Oo, buhay doon. Kahit late na tayo lumabas para
mag-uwi. Tapos the price?
Mura.
Yun talaga yung malaking factor doon, eh. Para sa mga kagaya natin na vegetarian, ayan. Super okay talaga mag-travel sa Hanoi. And in Vietnam generally, experience ko talaga yan. Super affordable talaga everything. Tara na, balik na tayo sa Hanoi ulit. So, yun fam, i-end ko na muna itong vlog. Magpapahinga man na kami ni Cass V. And babawi tayo ng tulog kasi hindi pa tayo nakapag 9 hours na sleep simula kagabi kasi bumiyahe tayo ng bus from Sapa to Hanoi. Tapos kanina umaga, ilang oras lang din. So ngayon, babawi tayo ng tulog. Tomorrow, we're gonna do a Klook tour ulit. No, share ko na lang bukas yung tour na gagawin natin. And then, at night, we plan to go to the Beer Street. No? Tapos, yun ang itinerary natin tomorrow. So before ko i-end itong vlog, please do follow me on my social media accounts. JM Bantisio sa Facebook, at JM Bantisio sa Instagram, and at JM_Bantisio sa TikTok. So maraming salamat fam sa panonood ng vlog na ito, and I'll see you on my next Hanoi vlog. Bye cuz! Good night!
Bye! Good night! Bye! Bukas ulit!